Pleased to be joined by the UFC light heavyweight champion, Jan Błachowicz, who will be defending his title against Glover Teixeira coming up here at UFC 266 on September 25th. Jan, how are you, sir?
I'm really good. Enjoyed my life, you know. Everything is perfect. I just start training, start doing my camp, but I still don't know what the date. You tell me the date, but I don't have this date on my email, anything. So I don't know. It's going to be 25.
But we're assuming it's in September we're hearing, right? Is that what you're hearing?
Yeah, I hope so, but I don't have anything on my email or you know, my manager don't know anything about the date. So I'm still waiting. But I'm the training, I'm the shape, so I'm going to be ready for sure for every date.
That's great. But before we get into your fight, I know you watched UFC 263 over the weekend. Of course, your last opponent, Israel Adesanya, ended up defeating Marvin Vettori. What did you think of Adesanya's performance and him getting the decision win over Marvin Vettori?
Yeah, good fight to watch. Good job. You know, I think that Vettori will do a little bit better when he take him down. But I think Adesanya, he do his homework. And now he will be, you know, much dangerous in this, on the ground, you know. He sweep him a couple times. So, you know, when Vettori will catch his back, he escaped really easy. So, yeah, nice job.
Were you surprised how quickly he got up from the ground when Vettori had him, you know, on the mat? It seems like he's worked on his ground game a bit.
Yeah, I was a little bit surprised. I think that Vettori, you know, that I show the world how to do this, you know, but Israel is one of the best in the world. He's you know, true champion. So, like I said before, he do his homework really well, and we see the result this in the fight. So, congrats.
Before the fight, were you expecting Adesanya to win?
Yeah, I think that he gonna win this fight. In this way, on the points. That was in my head before the fight. Exactly. This is how I see the fight, you know.
How cool is it seeing Brandon Moreno win the UFC flyweight title with everything he's been through? I know you saw that fight as well.
Yeah, you know, I enjoyed it. I was happy for him, you know. I know what he feels, so I just was happy, you know, that he deserved for this, you know, also work for this couple, you know, years. So also I was happy with him in this, you know. That was early morning in Poland. I was sleepy, but I was, you know, really happy and enjoyed it.
And what about Leon Edwards? Last thing talking about UFC 263, what did you think of his fight over Nate Diaz getting the decision? But it seems like everyone's talking about the fact that Diaz nearly finished him in the fifth round.
Yeah, but he don't finish him, you know. Mm-hmm. So maybe if he's gonna have, you know, 1 minute more, something like this, but he didn't. So we've got, you know, a decision for his opponent. That's it.
I agree with you. I think they got to look at the whole fight. If you were the UFC matchmaker, would you give Leon the title shot? Because he won the fight. I know he got rocked, but he still won the fight. Do you feel like he's done enough to deserve it? Because he's had, you know, 10 straight. I think he's on a 10 fight unbeaten streak.
Yeah, I have to check it, you know, because I don't know. So this is not my job, you know. This is job for UFC, not for me. I don't like to do this, so.
Okay, fair enough. I was just curious your opinion on it, is all, pretty much. We haven't talked since your win over Israel Adesanya. You know, great opponent. You know, a lot of people were counting you out. Where does that win rank in terms of career highlights, defeating a fighter like Israel Adesanya and handing him his first professional loss in MMA?
You know, for lots, a lot, you know, because I defend my belt, you know. That was really important for me. I defend the belt against someone like, you know, one of the best in the world, you know. So another, you know, something important for me. I was the first one who beat him. I think that if someone don't believe it before this fight, now people start to respect me. They give me, you know, they know that I'm, you know, true champion, and they, you know, now everybody will, you know, respect me before the fight. I think I'm not going to be underdog anymore. I don't care that I'm underdog or not, but I think the people who are doing this, they will start, you know, also, they don't put to me like an underdog anymore.
This fight with Glover, you mentioned not knowing the official date yet, but was the plan always to fight in the fall? Was this the right amount of time off, or did you want to fight a little bit sooner than that?
No, the first that was September 4th, yeah? But a couple weeks, 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, I don't remember, they sent a message that that will put the, this whole event a little bit, you know,
Yeah, there's some complications with, I know, I think the COVID
some
schedule,
complication.
I think,
they don't have the date. That's not going to be earlier for sure. It's going to be, you know, a little bit later. So I just wait for the date. But first of all, we talk about December 4. And I was, you know, I would like to, I was ready for this date. But for me, it's not a problem if I'm going to fight a little bit later. Even better for me, because I've got, you know, a lot of, still a lot of, job for, you know, for sponsors, for media, for stuff like this. So yeah, for me a little bit better.
Let's talk about Glover Teixeira, great opponent like yourself who's really sort of turned things around in his career. Stylistically, how do you feel like you match up against him in this fight?
You know, I think that he will try to take it down, you know, whole his fight will be, you know, use his boxing skills to try to, you know, push me to the cage, grab my, you know, one leg or double leg, and try to take me down and finish fight on the ground. That's gonna be his game plan for sure. You know, my game plan will be, you know, keep the fight on the feet and try to knock him out in stand up. You know, but even when he take me down, I think my jiu-jitsu is on his level, so we're gonna have a good fight on the ground. But I believe that my stand up skill is much better than his, so. Stand up will be for sure for me, and I will looking, you know, the knockout, boxing or head kick, something like this, and I'm gonna be ready for his, you know, wrestling and jiu-jitsu. Also, I have to be careful in, on, you know, on stand up, but you know, he gonna use only stand up for you know, for push me on the cage and try to catch me.
Glover is known for his durability. That's how he's actually won a lot, you know, his last couple of fights, is that his opponents have been trying to finish him and they haven't, and then he's able to take over in the later rounds. Because of that, does the game plan for you change, or do you still approach him like any other opponent?
You know, I will try to do this the same way like Gustafsson did. You know, he waited 4 rounds to knock him out, and if I have to wait even 5 rounds, I will wait for that. I will not push, you know, the tempo, because he know what he do. He is, you know, smart guy of experience. So, you know, he know how to, you know, what to do inside the cage. But I also, you know, I've got also a lot of experience. So I'm going to do this in Gustafsson way.
Your training camp, are you doing anything differently for this camp? Any cross training, or is it going to be just, you know, business as usual, as they say?
You know, same thing like always. The same, you know, camp like we did in, you know, when I take the belt, when I defend the belt, and it's only one thing what I change in every camp is just sparring partners. You know, we're gonna try to find someone who is similar to Glover, who's gonna be, you know, the similar style with good jiu-jitsu, good takedown, with good boxing, and we're gonna find the sparring partners. That's gonna be one change, but it's always be you know, I'm doing this when I'm do my preparation for the fight. We try to find a good sparring partners.
How do you see the fight playing out?
I see that I'm gonna win, you know, after a head kick or left hand knockout in the third or fourth round.
Okay, I like the confidence there. There's a lot of activity going on in your division right now, one being Yuri Prohaska, who just got this big win over Dominic Reyes. Do you think that that win, you know, earns him a shot at the title, or do you think he needs another fight in between there?
I think he, you know, decision. If UFC give, you know, first of all, I focus only about Glover. I don't
of
think
course,
about
yeah.
any different opponent. But I believe that I beat Glover and I defend my belt again. And after that, maybe they're going to give me Iri. But I think he have to do one more fight, I think, against Rakic. And then we're going to know who's going to be the next, you know, contender for the belt. And also we've got, you know, yeah, Rakic, and also we've got a lot of, you know, people forget about Ankalaev. I think he also is in the game. And maybe someone from this fighters will be my next opponent after the Glover. But like I told you before, right now my mind is set only about Glover.
Absolutely. No, I completely agree with that. There was some talk about Yuri maybe being the backup for your fight. Would you be okay with that if the, you know, if someone fell out, or would you want the UFC to just reschedule your fight if there was a, you know, a situation where, let's say, Glover couldn't fight, for example?
you know, I am a fighter. You know, I don't choose my opponent. If something's, I don't want to, you know, change anything. You know, for, I hope so that Glover will be my next opponent. I don't wish him any you know, injuries and stuff like this. And I hope so we're gonna fight. But if something changed, I don't have problem with that. But nobody said me that. You know, I just read this on internet. What you say? So I don't have any. You know, UFC don't talk about this with me.
Okay, that makes sense. What did you think of Yuri's win over Dominic Reyes?
Yeah, it was, you know, impressive fight. He got this weird style, but in good way, weird. It's working. But, you know, if you want, if I fight against Yuri, I know how to fight against fighters like him, you know. For me, he will be, you know, good opponent, you know, good for me, you know, for because I feel style like this, you know. I know how to fight against fighters like him. I just show the world how to beat crazy fighters.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. If you were to fight Rakic at some point, I'm sure you've looked at him as an opponent as well. How do you look at that fight stylistically if you were to fight Alexander Rakic?
You know, he also got good style, good stand-up. He's strong, young, strong guy. So another good opponent. But also I will find a way how to beat him. And you know, I destroy all of them, you know, if I'm going to have to. So, not a problem. If they give me Prochaska, I will destroy him. If they give me Rakic also. If they give me Ankalaev, no problem. I find a way how to beat all of them.
Okay. And just last one, because you mentioned him there, Ankalaev. If you were to fight Ankalaev style-wise, how do you look at that fight? Because I know every opponent's different, right?
So, yeah, everybody is different, you know. If they give me opponent, then I will start thinking about, you know, and then I start, you know, doing my game plan. But Ankalaev also, you know, knockout power, good stand-up. But so maybe on the ground, I will take him to the ground and finish fight over there. We'll see, you know. Right now, I focus, you know, about Glover.
For sure. Just one more thing on your division. Someone who used to be in your division, John Jones. I don't know if you've heard, but he's got new management. Do you think John Jones will fight again this year? Do you think they'll figure it out? Or do you think, you know, I know
think
you're
nobody
on
knows.
Yeah.
I think
I was
nobody
just
knows
your opinion
that.
On it.
I hope so. I hope so, you know, that he will fight in this heavyweight. We will see how he's going to look in this division. And I'm still, you know, I'm still waiting for him everywhere, every time, you know.
Yeah, no, I agree.
I hope
that.
So. He will stop, you know, talking this bullshit, and you know, he gave me what he promised me after when I beat Corey Anderson.
That's right. Yeah, you guys were supposed to fight. Hopefully that fight happens someday. Because you said you'd fight him at heavyweight if need be, right?
I can do this in heavyweight. For me, it's not a problem. You know, I can do this with him in the, you know, backyard. Even that, okay. I don't
Fair
care.
Enough.
You know.
Yeah. I wanted to ask you about a couple other fights. We have this Conor McGregor and Dustin Poirier fight coming up on July 10th. Who do you like in that fight? If I was to give you $500, or I don't know what the euro conversion would be, but if I was to give you some
Dustin
money,
Dustin Poirier.
Yeah, how do you think he wins?
Same style like in the second fight, you know, last fight. Because I think that McGregor right now he's you know, a businessman. He is not, you know, fighter. He is a fighter, still fighter, good fighter, but you know. Too much, you know, business in his head. That's why Dustin gonna win the fight.
And just your thoughts on this Tyron Woodley and Jake Paul boxing fight. Do you watch that at all? Any of the you know, the YouTubers boxing, the UFC fighters, and any thoughts on that?
I don't watch this, but I don't know. We will see. I see one, you know, movie how Jake Paul, I saw his training somewhere on YouTube or something, and he's pretty good in these boxing moves. So we will see. It's gonna be nice to watch. I hope so. Woodley gonna win this fight. He need to, you know, he have to show the world that you know, true sportsman will beat in good way guy from YouTube. So I'll
there you
keep
go.
My fingers for
that.
Him. But I, you know, he is YouTuber, but I think he spent a lot of time in the gym.
Very well said. Okay, just two more quick questions. I know you got to go. How's fatherhood been treating you? How's it being a father?
Yeah, it's good. You know, I enjoy it. Every day is a new adventure for me. Now it's a little bit easier than 3 months ago. You know, we have lucky because he sleep almost whole night. So he's really, you know, nice boy. He cry only when he is hungry. So, and normally he's just smiling and and that's it. So I think we've got lucky, and I enjoy it. I'm happy father, you know, he gave me big motivation to train, you know, because I do all also for his future right now. I work for his future, you know, so it's amazing feeling, and I wish the, you know, everybody have to feel this and live this himself, you know.
Absolutely. And got it. Before we get out of here, have you been watching the Euros? You know, Poland, I saw, lost the other day.
Yeah, it's sad, but you know, we all say always have, you know, big, you know, we try to, you know, we believe in them, and we give them a lot of support, you know, whole Poland believe that they one day they're gonna win something, but it's always like, you know, they lose everything. I don't know why. Maybe
except
they don't
in MMA, except in MMA, right? You're the champ.
You know,
so.
That's why, you know, maybe they, you know, I will go to the locker room and talk with them, you know, and give them motivation, stuff like this. And
you
they
should.
Start
it's
winning.
A great story, Jan. I agree with you. You've had a great career turnaround. So you gotta set that up. Maybe if you go in the locker room, they'll win next time.
Maybe that's gonna be, you know, the key.
Yeah,
so
I agree.
We have another game in Monday, so for sure I will watch it. On Saturday, sorry. In Saturday, so I'll, you know, watch the game and keep fingers for them. Send them energy, maybe this time.
Yes, for sure. Did you ever play soccer growing up?
Yeah, every kid in Poland plays soccer. Also, we play charity match because I support the charity foundation. They fight against cancer, so we do game MMA fighters against boxers, you know, and MMA fighters won this game. And we,
you
know,
you?
Make a lot
this?
Of money for that was 2 years ago, something like this.
Okay.
Big
who
stadium.
Played,
not
what,
big
what
stadium.
Other, sorry, what other MMA fighters were on your team?
From Poland, you know, that was only Polish fighters, you know, over there. I don't know that you... I don't
I
remember.
Didn't
Mateusz Gawlot was over there. Tibura was over there also, I think so. It was 2 years ago, 2 years or 3 years ago.
Okay.
Something like
that's
this.
Great. I'll have to look it up. That sounds really great. Jan, thank you so much for the time. I really appreciate it.
No problem.
You want to thank, any sponsors, any social media, I'll give you the last word.
I just want to thank you for this interview, fans for good, you know, because I got a lot of messages on my Instagram and Facebook from fans from all the world. So thank you for support. Send me a lot of energy in my next fight. Keep fingers for me and all the best for you guys.